about job securities these days, but the basic fact is, if you have a job, do you have a true security anymore? So how do you create a true security for yourself and your family in a hired today and fired tomorrow workplace? The answer is, create your own security by building a pipeline of residual income. So how do you do it? Good day, listeners. I am Kripa Soni, and today I am here to discuss Chapter 2, We Live in a Bucket Carrying World, of the book The Parable of the Pipeline. In this book, the author Brooke Hedges explains how virtually anyone can leverage their time, relationship and money to become a millionaire, why job security is an illusion, and why building pipeline of residual income is the only true security, why one pipeline is worth 1,000 paychecks, why building a pipeline is a secret behind million-dollar fortune, how a common man can leverage their time and relationship to become a millionaire and to build a pipeline of residual income. So how will we create it? And to learn more, let us get into this chapter. The author points out how 99% of the people carry buckets rather than building pipelines. That is to say, people tend to follow the same model or path as their parents or siblings follow, or as they perceive from their surroundings. For such 99% people carrying buckets, the idea of building pipelines is radical and risky, just like Bruno, the protagonist of this book. Only 1% of people believe in ongoing residual income. The problem lies in the roots, the underlying foundation. Our parents carried buckets to pay their checks, and so do we. People think that 1 lakh lemmings, that is 100 million bucket carriers, can't be wrong. So they assume that carrying buckets is the only way to get what we want in life. When this 99% people having bucket carrying mentality need more money, they come up with a solution to carry more buckets. Basically, earn more money by carrying more buckets. But this doesn't always work. This results in increase in consumer debts, increase in number of women working to support their families, people taking more than one mortgage on their single biggest asset, homes, to pay their bills, thereby all in all resulting in personal bankruptcies. Author also discusses that wealth does not necessarily mean income. If you make a good income each year and spend it all, you are not getting wealthier in any way. Wealth is what one accumulates rather than recklessly spending. Author personifies wealth to be stemmed from hard work, perseverance, planning, and most of all, self-discipline. He explains that buckets, no matter how big they are, will eventually dry up. Pipelines, on the other hand, are self-sustaining, but pipelines require a sacrifice. They don't build themselves. You have to take time and efforts to build up. He further explains why carrying buckets is not preferred according to him, because it will never be going to make one financially independent. One has to work each day to get paid. If one stops working due to illness or injury, layoffs and retirement, he will not be paid. In other words, he repeatedly emphasizes to build pipelines rather than carrying buckets. That is to say, create such source of passive income which will generate an income even if one doesn't work for a day or two. It will take time as well as effort to build pipelines at first, but it will be worth for it.
So, the author is of the notion that pipelines are your lifelines. That's all about lesson 2, dears. If you are interested further in learning that how to go ahead with the idea of pipeline more than the bucket plan, do watch our very next video.